down by Kanawha and Asher. That one has had a tornado on it, and it passed on the northern sides of Paul's Valley and is now rapidly pulling out of Paul's Valley southeast of Byers on the panhandle of McLean County. So that's still a dangerous storm as well. There's the one down by Cornish, which is out of our viewing area. Let's go to the storm scanner, comparing the May 3rd track with the May 20th track today. The May 3rd track is in yellow. The May 20th track today is in red. It was 20 miles long, and it was wider than May 3rd. EF4, EF5 damage, no doubt about that, likely EF5. And again, that was in the red shade. The one major difference is, other than a very similar track otherwise, is it turned more due eastward as it moved directly across the south central parts of Moore, whereas May 3rd turned more to the northeast and then the north.
She laid on top of them as the storm passed through. They are all alive, all accounted for. I also understand that the fourth, fifth, and sixth grade students were all accounted for and have been moved to a church that is in the area, and they are safe there. So right now, still unaccounted for, I suppose, kindergarten, first, second, and third graders. Still no word on those kids right now, but parents are just now beginning to arrive, kind of weep through all the mayhem, and as you can expect, they want to help. They're yelling at rescuers, why aren't they doing more? But believe me, these folks are doing everything they can to save whoever may be trapped in this debris. They are about to bring in some heavy equipment. I see a tractor about 50 yards from me that they're trying to get in through this mass of humanity so they can hopefully remove some of the heavier debris and get to what's underneath. But for those who may just be joining us, we do know that the third grade class was in a hallway in a classroom taking refuge from the storm, and that part of the building is completely gone. There are no walls standing of this school. It is wiped to the foundation. It's just nothing more than a big pile of debris. And like I said before, we can only hope and pray for the best that they can find these kids and these teachers alive.
So so we can pass this information on to parents, because there are some hysterical parents with Sarah Stewart right now whose children attend Plaza Towers Elementary. You're saying the fourth, fifth, and sixth grade students are all accounted for.
You've
and
got
where
mail.
Are they?
They are at a church, which is about a quarter mile from here. I will see if I can get the information. The name of that church, I don't know right now, but I was told by the teacher that those grades were escorted there before the tornado hit. They were not in the school at the time, so they are safe. I've just walked up on another triage center. It's essentially a red tarp that's laid on the concrete. There's a woman here who's...
Why they have to move a little bit slower than maybe the parents would like.
Absolutely. And let me tell you, there are obviously raw emotions out here, even among the rescue workers. When a sergeant with the Oklahoma City Police Department was asking people to get back, he was tearing up as he was confronted by a father who was upset that they weren't doing more. So obviously it's traumatic for everybody, and they are doing everything in their power to get these kids, to get these faculty members out of this debris.
Lance, we hate to deal with numbers, but parents who are watching need to hear these numbers so they can understand what's transpiring, because the numbers tell the story. When we talked to you about an hour ago, 30 minutes ago, you said that 75 students were believed to be in the school at the time the twister hit. Is that still the case?
That is the last count that we have, that in this particular part of the school, and this is the only area of the school that they're searching in right now, it's the south portion of the school. I was told that there were 75 kids who took refuge in that home, which typically has those reinforced cinder block walls. Those are typically the safest place to go when a tornado hits, if you can't go underground. Obviously, a tornado of this magnitude, it was unable to withstand to Mother Nature, and that area is wiped out. We did talk
The fourth, fifth, and sixth graders apparently were taken out of the school.
Before it hit.
Now, because you talked about 30 that were taken out of the school and relocated at a church.
That is correct. I spoke to a parent, and he said early on, initially, there were 30 children that were taken out of this particular area of the school, the south portion. Now, I don't know that those include the fourth, fifth, and sixth graders. I believe that they were gone before the tornado hit. They were evacuated and taken to a church, which is to our south. And I'm still trying to get some details on the name of that church. That's sort of a rallying point right now for parents as they're looking for the kid.
And just to clarify one more time, it's the third grade class that appeared to be in the hallway that searchers are looking for right now, some third graders. Is that correct?
That's what I've heard from one rescuer and also from a teacher, that this was the area where the third grade kids had taken refuge from the storm. And based on the young man who I saw pulled out a while back, I would say about the age, third grade. So maybe 8, 9 years old. And he was fine, along with a school teacher, and they have been taken off to a nearby hospital, I suspect, but they are alive and well. And the search continues tonight, and we're not going anywhere. We're going to be right here.
Lance West, thank you very much. We can't tell you how much we hope to be able to report that every one of those children is alive and well. We will continue to stay on top of it for you parents who can't make your way there. Our hearts go out to you.
Absolutely.
We feel for you. We're going to get you the information as quickly as we can and as accurately as we can.
Speaking of information, we need to get some new accurate information on the storm center right now. Let's go over to Mike Morgan for the latest on that. Mike.
Kevin, the tornado watch continues until 10 o'clock tonight. You see a lot of tornado warning counties here, but there are really just about three main storms in Oklahoma that are a potential threat to life right now in terms of tornadic activity. One is up here in Creek County. The other one is coming out of Garvin County. And the third one is in Love County to the southwest of Ardmore. Let's go to the storm tracker and we'll take a look at each one of these locations. And the motion continues to be to the east northeast at around 35 miles per hour. We have a storm up here moving into Creek County, which just had a confirmed tornado on it. This storm coming out of Garvin County is going to clip the northwestern corner of Pontotoc County and then go on up into southeastern Pottawatomie. In Pontotoc County, there's the time of arrival for that potential tornadic activity right there. And you see it is moving to the east northeast, putting these towns in danger, especially Kanawha is pretty much red line center line for that possible tornado, also on the northern sides of Stratford. So it's just now moving out of Garvin County, heading into Pontotoc County. The storm up here had a tornado on it just a few moments ago, south of Depew and northwest of Welty, a little ways northwest of IXL, southwest of Bristow. That is heading for Depew, on down toward Bristow at 528, and then down toward Beggs by about 6 p.m. Beggs is a suburb in southwestern Tulsa, and it's going to be heading through Creek County up into northwestern Okmulgee County, and then into southern Tulsa County. And then one more, this storm down here to the south, which is in Love County and Jefferson County. That is trying to head into Carter County for you folks in Ardmore. That is a tornado warning on that particular storm as well. You can clearly see the little notch there, a little bit of a hook south of Ringling, and that's down by, just came out of the Cornish area, Ringling, and it is heading for Lone Grove and Ardmore. And we would want to express to you that these are organized supercells down here, very, very large, and we would want you to give you a heads up in Ardmore and Lone Grove with the conditions that are over us today atmospherically. Obviously, a lot